Do you listen to YouTube on Apple Safari? Are you a discerning musician who likes to carefully compare vintage gear to analog emulations? Or check for phase issues and spectral correction plugins? Then I have news for you. Apple is ruining your audio. On my most recent video, Rezo, the latest Sooth 2 Challenger, my new friend David Asher commented that he was worried about the stereo image of the Rezo plugin I was testing. But he couldn't be sure because all YouTube videos are cut off at 16 kHz, so it's hard to get a fair idea of what information is getting cut off. Now, this is funny because I just watched Paul Third's excellent video called Can You Trust Your Video Editor? Where he figured out that YouTube has full frequency representation up to 20K unless you play the video back in the YouTube Studio backend, where Google uses a highly compressed version that adds a high-cut filter at 16K. So I told David that YouTube does not filter at 16K, but he insisted he still sees it on every video he tested, every single time. So now I had to test this out. For example, here's my last YouTube video, played from my YouTube homepage, recorded straight into Cubase via my Focusrite Scarlett. I'm playing this back in the Chrome browser, which is a version of Chrome, but without all that creepy tracking stuff. In this file, we see a full spectrum that ends up here at 20 kHz. Human hearing ranges from 20 Hz to 20,000 Hz, or 20 kHz, so this is fine, especially for a compressed video. I always assumed it would be much more compressed than this on YouTube, so I'm not really losing any high-end content when I upload my videos to YouTube, so this is ideal for detailed audio comparisons. Now, let's switch to Safari. Here's the exact same video played back through Safari. See that? Nothing above 16K. Same video, same high-def playback quality. Weird. Just to be safe, let's try lowering the playback quality to the lowest setting on both browsers. Here's Brave at 144p, and here's Safari at 144p. Same thing. Let's try a YouTube video of a commercial song. I've got Adele's Easy on Me here. I won't play it back because I'm enjoying my monetization, thank you very much. But we can see the same thing. Here's Brave browser. And here's Safari. Whoops, no 20K again in Safari. So it's time to get scientific up in here. I uploaded a video that has a sweeping tone from 20Hz to 20,000Hz. This is what it looks like untouched by codecs. Now here it is played in Brave. We see it goes all the way up to 20 kHz. So does Firefox for that matter. Now here it is in Safari. Yikes, there's just literally nothing above 16K. This is like the event horizon of an audio black hole. My friend David was able to reproduce this on his Mac using Safari, thus explaining why he always saw the 16K cutoff. And my brother verified that Safari cut off at 16K in his studio as well. So this seems to be a thing. And to test something not from YouTube, here's a movie trailer from Apple Trailers in Brave. And the same one in Safari. They both show the 16K cutoff, so that's coming from Apple servers. But the same trailer on YouTube in Brave goes up to 20K. On top of that, my man David tested browsers on iOS. Safari, Chrome, DuckDuckGo, Microsoft Edge, and the actual YouTube app itself, and they all had the 16K filter. Why does Apple hate 16K? Now, it must be said that when I played back a WAV file inside Safari on a Mac, it showed full 20K response, and things like Spotify Player and Amazon Music were the same across all browsers. And Apple's own Apple Music passed with flying colors when playing back in Safari, so there's no 16K filter ruining this, just a god-awful interface. And that brings us back to the crux of the issue. If you're an audio person who wants to carefully A/B and compare audio on geeky channels like this, you probably don't want to listen on Safari. For some reason, Safari has a brick wall 16K high-cut filter on all YouTube content, and pretty much any compressed format comes out looking like this. It's even worse on iOS, where switching to another browser won't help you. Now, I'm sure you're thinking, but Jeremy, most of us adults can barely hear anything above 16K. Yeah, you may be right. But let's look at a 128 kilobits per second MP3. Look, the same 16K cutoff. So basically, in Safari, we get something similar to a 128 kbps MP3, instead of playing the full range of our content. We left 128 kbps MP3s behind in the dust decades ago because we all agreed they sounded like crap. And now Safari is dragging us back to 1997. Plus, it's applying a brick wall filter to a file that already has a brick wall filter applied at 20 kHz. So that's potentially changing the audio even further by reprocessing it. I suspect that most of us audio purists want to know when they're getting the full picture when deciding whether to part with our hard-earned cash for a plugin or hardware. Maybe you can't hear 16K, but I suspect most of us are uncomfortable knowing that a video is completely cut off at a certain frequency when it isn't applied to the source by YouTube. It can affect credibility for audio reviewers. And what is Apple's game here? Are they trying to save us all bandwidth on our internet bill? Or do they optimize the engine for phones where curbing data usage is more important? So this is yet another reason why I won't switch to the world's most boring browser. Don't get me wrong, I'm an Apple fan through and through, but Safari is just not my bag. And I certainly won't be listening to YouTube on Safari, and neither should you. Note, I wasn't able to test this on a Windows computer. If anyone feels like testing some browsers on their Windows box, please feel free to leave your findings in the comments below. And let me know what you think. Are you outraged? Do you care? That's all for now. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and head over to paleblue.ca and sign up for my newsletter. I'm giving away a free contact instrument, mixing cheat sheet, and you can get information on my new mini course about mixing. Until next time, mix well.